Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. The topic for today's session is file matching logic in Cobol. In this video, we will deep dive into the world of Cobol, explicitly focusing on file matching logic and how it is implemented in Cobol programs. This is a crucial concept that plays a significant role in data processing tasks in Cobol. This video is divided into three different sections. First one is an introduction to Cobol. In second section, we'll talk about Cobol file processing capabilities. In this section, we'll talk about file matching concept and we'll try to understand the working principle with the help of a flow diagram. We'll also look at a sample Cobol program to understand how you can implement file matching logic in your Cobol program. And finally, we'll wrap up this session with tips and tricks section. So let's get started with introduction to Cobol. Cobol, or Common Business Oriented Language, is a high-level programming language that is primarily used in business, finance, and administrative systems. It is predominantly used in various sectors such as banking and finance, retail, and aviation. Cobol is a robust programming language and has exceptional file handling capabilities. Now let's talk about Cobol file processing capabilities. So as you know that file handling is crucial for any programming language, and believe me, Cobol is excellent in file handling. It provides robust and flexible mechanism for organizing file, accessing and manipulating data. Cobol file processing capabilities enable programmers to build efficient and dependable solution, from simple read and write operation to complex file matching logic. And remember, Cobol supports three types of files, that is sequential, index, and relative. And each type has its own unique characteristics and use case. Now let's move on to file matching in Cobol. So file matching in Cobol is used when we need to combine two or more files based on a common key field. It is like merging two lists based on a common element, and this is particularly useful when you're dealing with large data set. And the process involved reading record from each file, comparing the key fields, and then writing the match record to an output file. Now let's talk about the flow diagram that explains the underlying working principle of file matching logic in Cobol. So start and end actually indicate the starting and ending of the process or the program. After that, you have open file section where you're going to open the file in the desired mode. In case if file is opened successfully, then you're going to proceed with further processing. In case file is not open due to some error, then you're going to display the error message and you're going to terminate the processing of the program. Now let's assume that our file is opened successfully. So in this case, we're going to read the first record from both file, that is from file 1 and file 2. After reading the record, compare the key fields of the record from the two input files. If the key match, then write the combined record to the output file and read the next record from both input files. Now the second case is that your key does not match, and again there are two possibilities. First one is file 2 key is greater than file 1 key. So in this case you're going to read the next record from file 1 only. And the second possibility is that your file 2 key is less than file 1 key. So in that case you have to read the next record from file 2 only. And you should always remember that this comparison logic has to be implemented in loop so that it should be executed for all records that is present in the input file. And for loop, you can either use inline perform statement or probably perform until statement or any other variant of perform statement as per your business requirement. Apart from that, if you encounter end of the file condition for any of the file, then either you should stop the processing of the program or probably you can write all the remaining records from the other file into a non-match file. Or probably you can skip those records because they fall in the category of non-match records. Now before we deep dive into our sample Cobol program, I would like to mention that this flowchart represents a simple file matching logic process. Depending on a specific requirement of your COBOL program, you might need to adjust this process. For example, you might need to handle errors or exception, or you might need to perform additional processing on the records. But this flowchart should be a good starting point for understanding file matching logic in COBOL. Now let's talk about our sample COBOL program. So this program is picked up from our COBOL Complete Reference course, which was published last year on all major education platforms, for example, Udemy, TutorialPoint, or Skillshare. So if you want to check out this course, then I've provided the link in the description. Now coming back to the program, first of all, we have identification division, which is used to specify details related to the program. That is the program name, author, and the date on which it is written or compiled. After that, we have given a brief description of the program. So this program will generate monthly report for the list of employees whose process code is P in the list file. Apart from that, this program will also fetch relevant employee details from the employee master file. Now the purpose of this program is to demonstrate COBOL file handling capabilities and how you can implement the file matching logic in your COBOL program. So this program will read data from the sequential file and will write data to a sequential file, which is basically your output file. Now in this program, we have actually used three files. First one is your employee list file and employee detail file. So employee detail file is actually a master file. An employee list file is actually a simple file which is being used as a driver file. And then we have output file, which is basically your monthly report. And all the input files which is used in this program are sorted and they do not have any duplicates. Now the next section is environment section, where we specify the details related to your file. So we have defined the input file and the output file. And remember, the organization for all these three files is sequential. Then we have data division, which is used to define both input and output file layouts. After that, we have working storage section, which is used to define your working storage variable or temporary variables that you have used in your COBOL program. And in this section only, I've used a couple of temporary variables, and these variables are group variable, and they are actually used to define the layout of the report. So every time I'm going to write a record to a report, I'm going to move value to these variables, and then I'm going to write that in my report. For example, head 1 and head 2 will print the report headers. Then we have column head 3, which will print the column headers. The next one is detail line, and this group variable will be used to print the details from the match record to your report. Then we have trailer line, and this particular variable will be used to print the summary in your report. And finally, we have a variable that is report-blank-line. So this will be used to print blank line in your report as and when it is required. Now the next division is procedure division, where you specify your entire COBOL program logic. So first of all, we have a paragraph that is perform A000-int-val. So this paragraph will initialize all our working storage variable. The next one is perform B000-open-file. So this particular paragraph will open all the files in the desired mode, that is in the input mode as well as in the output mode. After that, we have next statement, that is perform C000-print-header. So this particular paragraph will going to print the report headers. After that, we have next paragraph, that is E000-read-list-file and F000-read-employee-file. These two paragraphs will going to read the first record from the input files. Now the next perform statement is perform D000-process-records. Now in this section, we have actually implemented our file matching logic. So let me showcase what all we have implemented in this section. So first of all, we have a paragraph that is D010-process-record. And in this paragraph, we have an inline perform statement to implement loop so that our piece of code is executed for all the records which is present in the driver file. After that, we have used the evaluate statement to compare the value of key fields and take necessary action based on the output of comparison. Now, if you look at the evaluate statement, you can clearly understand that we have specified four different conditions. First three conditions are for our file matching logic, and the last condition with other statement is for exceptional handling. So first one is when the list file employee number is greater than master file employee number, then in that case, we're going to read the record or the next record from the master file. The second condition is in case if input list file employee number is less than the master file employee number, then in that case, we're going to read the list file again for the next record. And the third condition is if the list file employee number is equal to master file employee number, that means it's a match case. In that case, we're going to check the list file process code. If it is P, then we're going to populate the details in the detailed record, and then we're going to write that into a report. And after that, we're going to read record from list file and master file. And after processing all the records in the input file, we're going to print the summary and close all the files that are open in the program. And finally, terminate the processing of the program. So this is how you can implement file matching logic in your COBOL program. Now let's move on to our last section, that is tips and tricks section. And in this section, we'll talk about a couple of important tips and tricks for implementing file matching logic in your COBOL program. So first one is always ensure that the file that is being matched are sorted in an order of the key field. Second thing is you should use appropriate file handling verb like read, write, rewrite, or delete as per your business requirement. And the last one is handle exception using appropriate condition in your COBOL program. So in summary, file matching in COBOL is a powerful feature that allows us to efficiently process and manipulate data. It is a fundamental concept that every COBOL programmer should master. Last but not the least, if you like this video, then please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel because we need your support to grow our YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching the video.